You've definitely heard of Starship. It's the largest rocket ever flown, made of stainless steel, that will take humans to the moon and Mars. It's reusable, and it's very powerful. In fact, it's twice as powerful as the Saturn V, the rocket that took humans to the moon 50 years ago. But I don't think many people understand exactly how Starship works. How did they design it to be reusable? Why is it made of stainless steel? And what are the differences between cargo and crewed variations? In this video, I'll explain that and other interesting things about the Starship. The rocket consists of two stages, the booster, called Super Heavy, and the Starship itself. Let's start with the booster first. It's 9 meters in diameter and 71 meters tall, which equals to the height of a 23-story building. It has 33 Raptor engines, which at full power can produce 74.4 millinewtons of thrust. To put that into comparison, the Saturn V rocket has maximum thrust of 34.5 millinewtons. But to give you even a better idea of how powerful the Starship is, the Falcon 9 rocket has a maximum thrust of 7.6 millinewtons, and Soyuz 2 has a maximum thrust of just 0.8 millinewtons. So, Starship is very powerful. Now, let's talk about reusability. How does it work? After the second stage separates, the booster immediately performs a flip maneuver. After that, it performs a boostback burn, which brings in a trajectory toward the landing site. While it descends, the booster needs to be stabilized. For this purpose, Super Heavy is equipped with grid fins. Invented in the USSR in the 1950s, the Soviets used them on their ballistic missiles in the 70s. SpaceX adopted them in 2014, and since then they use them on Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy boosters, as well as Super Heavy. Once the booster is close to the ground, it ignites the engines for the final time, slowing down the booster entirely. But here comes something interesting. If you're familiar with other SpaceX rockets, you know that Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy boosters have legs. I mean, you've definitely seen the booster landing at least once. But if you look at the Super Heavy, there are no legs. Then how does it land? Well, they catch it. With chopsticks. Like Mr. Miyagi from Karate Kid. You know, when he was catching a fly with chopsticks. However, in this scenario, it's the booster that needs to get into the chopsticks. Imagine how precise it should be. Man, I love engineering. Like, the booster comes from space, pretty fast, and it's able to land directly into the chopsticks. It's so cool. I love engineering. But anyway, if you look closer at the top of the Super Heavy, you'll see these hard points. This is where chopsticks hold the booster. After that, they do some checks and the booster can be reused again. Now let's talk about the most common question people have when they see Starship. Why is it made of stainless steel? It's surely an unusual choice, and not that many rockets are built out of this material. Early versions of the Atlas were made out of stainless steel. And aside from that, I don't think there are any other stainless steel rockets. If you know any, let me know in the comments. So why did they choose stainless steel? Before that, SpaceX was experimented with composite materials. It seems like a great choice because carbon fiber offers exceptional strength and it's lightweight, which is important when it comes to rockets. The problem though is that it's expensive, and the affordability of space travel is one of the main goals of SpaceX. They want to make space travel cheap. I mean, this is why they reuse the rockets and always look for ways to cut costs. But it's not the only reason. Stainless steel has greater heat resistance than carbon fiber. It's quicker to produce and it's more durable long term. So, although it's heavier than composite materials, eventually the pros outweigh the cons. That's why they decided to use stainless steel on both the Super Heavy booster and on the Starship. Talking about Starship, let's talk about how it's reused, because it's reused differently than the booster. While the booster descends vertically, using its engines to slow down, Starship descends on its belly, which creates a lot of drag, slowing down the rocket without the need to burn the engines. SpaceX calls it a belly flop maneuver, and it's a pretty unique way of landing a rocket. But also it's dangerous. As it descends, the ship is enveloped in super hot plasma. Not only does it block radio waves, cutting down the communications, but also the extreme temperatures can damage the rocket. For this reason, Starship has a heat shield. The heat shield consists of thousands of hexagonal black tiles that can withstand temperatures of 1400 degrees Celsius. Since the Starship is made out of stainless steel, which as I mentioned has a high heat resistance, the ship only needs the heat shield on one of its sides for extra protection. While the Starship descends, it needs to be controlled. For this reason, it has four flaps that let the Starship maneuver. They're covered in a heat shield as well. Now, let's talk about different variations of the Starship. Keep in mind that once the Starship is fully finished, SpaceX plans to retire all of its current rockets. So they will retire the Falcon 9, the Falcon Heavy, and also crewed and cargo variants of the Dragon spacecraft. What it means is that there will be multiple variants of the Starship. For satellite launches, Starship will have a large cargo door, similar to the one that the shuttle had. It'll open to release cargo. For Starlink launches specifically, it'll have a dispenser rack, similar to a Pest Candy dispenser. Crewed Starship will have a pressurized crew section and life support system. For long duration missions, such as crewed flights to Mars, it'll have private cabins, communal areas, centralized storage, solar storm shelters, and a viewing gallery. And the variant of the Starship that will land on the Moon will have an elevator to lower crew and cargo onto the lunar surface, a solar array, and modified landing legs. Of course, there are many other interesting things about the Starship. For example, to get to high energy targets like the Moon and Mars, Starship will need to be refueled in orbit. That's quite challenging to say the least. But I think this topic deserves its own video. So let me know in the comments if you would like to hear more about this or other things about Starship that I didn't cover in this video. Thank you for watching. See you soon.